got, oh, car in the wall. That is Reed Sorenson up in the wall in turn one and two, and now he's got fire.
Big hit. Looked like he had a problem getting in there to be hit that hard on the right front.
Right. Did it not look to you like a right front going down? Maybe too much camber here early? There's some discussion about right front.
Oh, Tony Raines involved too, Ricky. Raines was involved somehow too. We'll try to get a look at the replay for you.
It's a big hit, Ricky. We'll have to, hey, look, you know, normally when a car hits the wall that hard, something has gone wrong. But we do see Reed moving around in there. Got his window net down. That in NASCAR means that he is okay.
He needs to get out of there. The thing obviously still on fire, but
safety crew's coming over to douse that fire right now. That's on the right side of the car, and he is sitting just at the exit of turn number two here at this 7/8 mile speedway. That's a good sign. Reed hopping out and walking away. Whew. And here is Sorenson.
Oh, yep. Yeah.
Oh. You heard the pop.
Yeah.
Sure did. And Ricky, as you were talking about the camber, I hope that's not the reason that the Braun cars have the speed that we're talking about, because if they're all set the same way, they better take a look at the others.
That is such a great point. Drivers love right front camber. It feels good. It's fast.
This is the look from Michael Annette, our in-race reporter, and he sees Sorenson just go straight up.
It feels good. It's fast, but there's no longevity to it.
When you blow a tire like that, I guess you're just along for the ride.
Yeah, it's not a fun ride either. We blew a right front there and hit the wall pretty hard. Never raced here before, so I was looking forward to it. I don't even know what position we were in, but we had a pretty good car, passed a lot of cars. And a Dollar General car wasn't too bad for not even getting to practice. I think the car had four laps of practice on it. But I think the reason we blew right front was some type of brake cooling issue. Something was going on with our brakes pretty big there, so I don't know if the brake fans weren't working or what kind of issue we had. But I don't think we ran over anything. I think the bead got melted. And the last five laps there, I was trying not to use the brakes at all, and it was too late, I think. So this is the first DNF for us. Hopefully we don't have any more, but just wish we got to take the Dollar General car a little bit further along, but it's part of it.